to the foul on the interior. There's always a lot of pushing and shoving. That will be St. John Paul with the last opportunity before halftime to try to take the lead.
8.5 seconds remaining. 21. Over the Waller. Drives inside. Connects. 28-26. St. John Paul Eagles lead over your North Broward Eagles. I'm Sam Gelfand with Ben Curtis with Grand West Sports Twitch TV, the home of the Eagles. We'll be right back in 10 minutes with a start of the second half. Don't go anywhere. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Coconut Creek, Florida. For this game between the North Broward Eagles and the St. John Paul II Eagles, we're about to get back underway in the third period. My name is Sam Gelfand, joined by Ben Curtis. And I have to say, the ending of that first half was about as disappointing as the L.A. Chargers' new logo.
Oh, that's a low blow, but that is very disappointing, Sam. It was 26 apiece. Then St. John Paul got a late basket with just about 2 seconds to go. Until the end of the first half, North Broward go right back in, and they're only down by two. Not a bad position to be, especially given the height advantage that St. John Paul II has. So they're right in this. We'll see what they can do in the second half.
Henningsen misses the layup, and now it's going to be caught by Sajani Pura. Henningsen missed with the guarding, 21-0. Over to number 12 of Poku. Fisher from the outside just barely gets out of the basket. Got to hit those reverse toilet bowls. That's a technical term for it, isn't it?
Is that in the basketball dictionary, Sam?
There's a basketball dictionary?
I'm sure somewhere.
I'm familiar with the regular dictionary. Now Ralph over to Denny. Sets up the pass at the table from Long. Bounces off. Ralph now with the rebound over to Henningsen. The shot, no good again. Jetta with the rebound. And there's no one there.
That's going to be a backcourt violation, Sam.
No one there.
A good sign for North Broward that those offensive rebounds, two offensive rebounds in one possession for North Broward. And it was patience during the rebound, bro. Rinash Jenna off the ball immediately. He went for it after the ball had already been unable to be played by Poker.
But that was a bad sign for North Broward as well. We're going to go through this great night today. And that they took, what, four shots on that? Seems like it was a single one.
Those shots are eventually fall, Sam. I think it's more important right now that they're getting those second chance opportunities. The shots will fall eventually.
North Broward staying in this game. 28-26, although St. John Paul still leads. 53 remaining in this period. What do you think North Broward needs to do to come up victorious in this game?
I think they just have to get the ball to their playmakers more. I mean, Jake Zabel leading the team with 12 points. I think that they have to let him facilitate the ball a little bit more, get him and Roush involved a little bit more in the three-point area of the game, and just be able to make those shots and execute defensively. They'll be fine.
Now St. John Paul is going to inbound it. Over to number 13, Fisher. Over to Lawler, who hands it off to Green to Fisher. Now Green, back to Fisher. Over to Lawler. They can't penetrate the paint, having the same problem right now that North Broward is having in the first half. Over to Fisher on the other side. Huge block, but Simo can't come up with the layup. Good defense by North Broward.
It's going to stay St. John Paul in the second bubble. That was very good defense, especially on the interior. North Broward not allowing St. John Paul to get into the paint, where they have been fantastic tonight.
And now Preen's going to control over the pitcher. Bontelema decides against taking it. Simo from long makes the three.
St. John Paul trying to beat North Broward at their own game. I would be fine if I was North Broward. Let St. John Paul take both of those opportunities.
Looking at their own game, 20 rounds is a big three. And now Fisher passes it over. In the corner, another three. It's good. It's been a bow of the downtown shots this half so far.
If these teams are trading threes, I am more confident in our ability, if I'm North Broward, to make our three-pointers more than St. John Paul.
St. John Paul averages 46.7 points per game. They're well on track. And Denny comes down with a three. And now they're controls again, Jable.